Hello everybody, this is film number 66. In this film I will show you how I take three anchor winches, of which one no one is working, and building one that is in working order. Lean back and enjoy the film. This is anchor winch, and I have actually three of those, but all of them have some kind of defect, and the idea is to build those three together to one piece, because I want to have that on the boat when it go into the water, because it's part of the security gear on the boat. But I need to find out if the engine is running around, so that is what I'm gonna test now. So I just take a battery, and I believe this is the minus. This will be. Nothing is happening. I will see what I can do about that. I've taken out another battery to check if the other one was flat, but this one is never flat unless I have been using it a lot, and I have not been using it a lot. So there could be this carbon pieces inside that could be hanging, so I have to take it more apart. But now I know how control box I need to buy for it, because it have three connectors, and there's another piece with four connectors, but this one have only three. So I guess I just have to take the two others out also, and then just take them apart and see what I can get out of it. The idea now is to try to give some power to those two anchor winches here, windlass, and to see if they are turning or not. Otherwise I have to order some pieces. So I will see if I can make them turn around. Nothing much is happening there. Then I will try on the other one. Oops. Yay! Wow, that is good. And that is also good. Okay, I have an anchor windlass that is working. So now I just have to somehow clean it up and make it work. That is marvelous. So this piece is going to a side, and I can maybe use it as spare parts, but yeah, it's a different engine, so I'm not sure that it's that I can switch the part without switching all other kinds of stuff too. So I will have to see, but it will definitely need to be cleaned up and painted, and maybe some new oil. And yeah, this is nice. This one was given to me as a present, because the guy who is a friend of me, he was selling this one. I didn't know it, but I was seeing on the net, and then he wanted a bottle of rum for it, and I told him that I had another one, and I will build those two together so that I could get one winlass out of it. And and then the guy who owned this one say, I also have one, you can have it just for spare parts. So I didn't get pay anything for this one, but it's very nice to have it as spare parts. So I'm very pleased even through that it's not working. So yeah, I'm this is very good. Well, what I need to do now is to build this piece into a place where I can test it properly. That means I need to have a fuse on the line, and I because otherwise I'm risking ruining the battery, maybe. And I have to test it properly. That means I have to test it where it's it stands. So now, first of all, I will clean the cable, and I need some new cables also for it. But I will clean it first to see what to expect or what to get out of it. I tested this one, and it's when it's taking in the anchor, it's working okay. But when you have to take the anchor out, it's just like freewheeling, or it's not like going around, but it's have like yeah, that's in neutral, so to say. It might be that it's the way it have to be, or no, it's the wrong way to say it. It might be that it's the way it is, and so be it. I have to talk to some friends before I decide what to do. But it could also be that there are something wrong, because I believe that to make it go in, to make it spin freely, you have to loosen this piece here, and so that it doesn't connect that tight, and then it will run freely. I'm not sure. And this is the other one I have, and it have a wrecked engine, and I know that the carbon pieces on this one is dead. And I'm not sure if you can see it. Actually, these three engine have three winches have three different kinds of engine, but I will go with this one I know is working, and I think I will take it off this piece and mount it on this one, because this look better than the other. So I think that it might be a little less used, and it's might not been worked, so it have been wrecked, but it have been standing, so it have been wrecked. It will be a good guess. So the first thing I will do is to take the engine off here and off this one, and then switch them over. And then you can see here I don't have the chain wheel. And then I will take probably this wheel over here. I'm not sure, but one of the wheels, it could also be this one, and mount it here. And then I will see how I'm doing. But I think that right now it looked like the best solution. I will think I will take some compressed air and try to blow them clean. This one I had for I bought it for a steel bow I had 20 years ago, and it was for sale wrecked. And the boat was only 27 feet. And the idea was to mount it on the boat and just use it as a hand anchor winch, because it will only be like a 30-pound anchor or something like that. And you can easily take that in by hand on a winch. And it was cheaper to buy this one racked than buy the smaller one working. And the idea was just to take all this away and then put some blind plate on it. But I sold the boat and nothing happens. And I lost this piece sitting here. I might have it lying around somewhere. I just can't find it. But I can take some of the other parts. Or maybe even build a new one. I don't know. But then I bought this one because I want to take the engine from this part and build on this one or vice versa, whatever. And I got this one. So now the deal is just to get those winches connected. It also looked like the guy who had this, he didn't use that big cable, but yeah, that might also be one of the mistakes by this one. But I will see what I can do. What I'm doing now is I'm trying to take the carbon pieces from this engine and build in to this engine over here, and that is because this one died because the carbon pieces had corroded into the rest of the engine, and I tried to take the engine apart to switch from that one to this one, so that engine that is working could come over on this one, but it's very tight. And on before I have been talking to some friends about how I can take it apart, then I'm not doing anything because I don't want to ruin it. And this one have four connections point, and this engine have three connections point, and three makes sense to me because one is the negative piece and the other two is the positive for the one way around and for the other way around. But why there are four points, I'm not sure what the idea is by that, but I'll have to look into some diagram or something like that to find out, or maybe even ask some people what the idea is with the four connections point. But what I'm trying to do is take the carbon from this part and build into this one, and then when I know why there are four points, then I will try to put some electrical power on this one to see how it turns. So, but yeah, I will take the last one out here. Hope not to wreck it. So. Actually, this engine looked quite good, so I'm a little bit confused why it won't turn. But I will have to put those pieces into this one here somehow. Mm-hmm. It didn't help by this one by changing the carbon pieces. So I guess the next thing will be to take the engine from that one, but I will ask a friend first if you have some good advice on this one, because maybe I'm doing something wrong, but yeah, I'll have to ask him first. For helvede. Det var ikke meningen. I'm actually not quite sure what just happened, or actually that means I do know what happened. When I took this engine off, it was only the engine that was coming off the machinery, but this one, the whole shaft came out with it. So somehow I have to take this part of the engine so that I can get that part back in and on that engine over there. But it's looked like it have been corroded, this piece have been corroded together. And yeah, I just have to fix it somehow. But it doesn't look that bad actually, it's just, it was not the idea that it should come off. Or at least I thought not it should come off, but I will have to see what I do. But yeah, this is a little strange. So I hope you enjoyed the film, and I have to apologize to my subscribers. Normally I try to put up a film every once a week, but at the moment, due to work, I'm working outside, and I need, when the weather is good, I need all the time I can get there. And of course I want to have the boat in the water, so I'm also working very hard on that. Then I have the apartment where I'm living, I'm moving out of that one, so I have to clean all my junk out of there and paint it and all other kind of stuff. And that is also taking some time. And I have to admit, so it's gonna be the filmmaking that has been a little less priority in all this yeah, work stuff. The idea is still to get the boat into the water before 1st of April, and there's a good chance I'm not gonna succeed that, but that is what I'm working on. And so you have to have a little patience with the film. If you're not a subscriber or not a watching on the blog waltzingalma.wordpress.com, then you could subscribe, and then you'll get a ping when every time I put up something new, and then you can always unsubscribe later. That is a good way to be informed. Otherwise, I hope to see you when I have some new material ready for you. I have lots and stuff. I continue filming. It's more the editing stuff that I'm a little behind with. So in the order that I have the time, I put something up for you. Hope to see you next time.